Para terminar la cobertura del lanzamiento mundial del Lamborghini Huracán, ahora con Alex Lloyd, ex piloto y ahora periodista de yahooautos.com.
Alex, so you're a unique journalist because you're not only like us, like me, like I'm a regular driver, but you have professional experience. So I want to hear your opinion about this car. We haven't driven it on the road, but what about in the truck?
Yeah, I'm very impressed. I think there's some bits that I'm starting off on the negative side, and we'll turn to the positives. But we have the dynamic steering on this now, which obviously makes it light at low speed and then get heavier as you increase lock. That isn't particularly nice on the track. It feels a little rubbery. And also we've got the magnetic ride, the adaptive suspension.
Yeah.
And I was told by one of the engineers that the passive suspension is actually better for the track because it's stiffer and a little bit lighter. So I think if we could take the dynamic steering off, put the passive ride on, and then upgrade the tires to the optional courses, then I think we'd have a really good track car. But because that was the only thing I was a little... The steering just didn't quite feel like I had the connection there.
Okay, let me interrupt you there, because are we talking about a guy with the experience of you with IndyCar, like professional driving, or a guy like me who has not that much experience on the track?
Well, I think, and Lamborghini said that for most people, they probably won't care. You know, they won't really notice it on the track, and it will be preferable on the road.
And that's why I asked, because you know much more than anybody else.
I think for most people... I think certainly the Magna Ride and the adaptive suspension is going to be the way to go, because everybody's going to use this car on the street. Very few people are going to take it to the track. For those track day guys, I think there's a better setup than what we have driven so far. But I've been very, very impressed. I think the grip level's been great. The car's very predictable. There's not a load of understeer, which is often when you have the all-wheel drive.
Uh-huh.
So and it's fast. It just feels like a good amount of power, a good amount of grip, and it's fun. You can play around with it a little bit. It's very stable. It's not going to bite you or do anything evil. So I really enjoyed myself in it. I really found it a very good, engaging car. The gearbox is a lot better now, being dual clutch. You know, you can shift in the middle of a corner without the thing wanting to swap ends on you, as it does in the Aventador. And actually chasing the lead driver in the
Aventador,
he looked like he was having a more difficult time than I was. I mean, he's sliding around and really, you know, wheels spinning and getting himself out of shape, where it was very comfortable in the Huracan, just cruising up behind him. So I was very, very impressed. And I think if you did those extra bits for the track, I think it will be even better. But the setup here is where supposedly it's going to shine a lot on the street.
Exactly.
So I'm looking forward to doing that.
What about the design? Do you like the design, exterior, interior?
I do. There were some complaints that I heard from some people saying, it's a little too safe on the design, like it to be a little more extravagant. I think it's really good. I think it still holds a really big presence. It makes a statement like a Lamborghini should.
You know it's a Lamborghini.
You know it's a Lamborghini immediately. Yes, it's a bit like a mini Aventador, but there's also some Murcielago in there. And I really like it. I think it's got a good sound to it as well. It's an engaging car. It catches attention. But at the same point, as we found today, it really performs well on track too. It's not just as the Aventador, it's really just for show.
Yeah.
And when you start getting into the corners, you really unearth some difficulties with it. Whereas this, you really don't. You have to pick at little bits for negatives, because the negatives really aren't that big.
Exactly. What's your opinion on the decision of going with a natural aspirated engine instead of a turbo or something like that?
You know, I like it. I think it's rare now, because everybody's downgrading and, you know, adding turbos, and I think there's good strong torque from quite low down. I think they said, you know, max is peak torque is maybe 6,500, but at 1,000 RPM you get 75% of it, and I certainly never felt like I was lacking for torque. You know, I think as McLaren and Ferrari and Porsche are doing on their really, you know, the really high end, their hypercars, the using the turbo really works when you can add those electric motors to fill in that torque gap. But I think in a car like this, when you're not looking at that kind of technology, naturally aspirated, you know, and there's something about the V10 sound or an Aventador, a V12 sound. I mean, that's
something else.
It is, and you're not gonna, they're just becoming rarer and rarer. So I like the fact that we're staying with that here.
Great. Alex Lloyd from Yahoo Autos. So that's where we can find all your stuff, where you do your reviews and all that?
Every day on Yahoo Autos.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Alex.
Thank you.
Keep enjoying the car here in NASCAR.
Will do. Thanks.
Thank you.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.